We have a health alert this morning for parents of young boys. Not getting them the HPV vaccine now could be putting them at greater risk for cancer as adults.
In fact, it's happening to a growing number of men. Dr. Kira Cooley is here. She's an OBGYN with St. Francis. Good to have you.
Thank you for having me.
Seeing an increase in throat and mouth cancers.
Yes, we are.
Among men.
Yes.
When the HPV vaccine first came out, it was still kind of controversial. But it was targeted more toward girls, or at least as a parent, I felt that.
Right.
Was that the case?
Right. So initially, it was targeted towards the girls because of cervical cancer. You know, we do the screening every year.
Right.
But now we're seeing an increase in the oral, throat, anal cancers in men.
Okay.
Which is huge.
So the vaccine itself, it can actually, what, prevent cancer? But still, what's the debate? Why aren't more people getting it?
I think we're just scared sometimes because we're not aware of what the risk could be of the HPV vaccine. And then we weren't as aware about the men getting the cancers, but now we're more aware.
Well, and parents are a little squeamish because it sort of feels like we're acknowledging that our children may be sexually active before we want them to be. And in reality, I mean, is that legitimate?
No. So we want the kids to get vaccinated when they're 11 or 12. That's the best time before they are sexually active.
It actually
so you're talking
takes,
about both boys and girls.
Right, boys and girls, it, 11
to 12. Is it more
12,
effective if they get it that young
it
as opposed to 14 or 15?
Definitely more effective if they get it at 11 or 12.
Okay.
They have an increased immune response, which is what we want, that protects against the HPV.
So what conversation should parents be having right now? What should they be saying to their children about this?
So basically, they want to let them know this is a widespread thing. There's so many people infected with the HPV. They're over like 80 million new cases a year.
Wow.
300 million cases like of people already infected with the HPV.
And does it always develop into cancer?
Not always, but if we get that HPV vaccine, it'll definitely give you that better chance.
Okay.
Even if you've had HPV or been exposed to it, it's better to get the vaccination. There are over 150 types of HPV, and they can protect against the other types.
So should adults even get it?
So we recommend from 11 to 26.
Okay.
If you're at risk, that's usually when the insurance will cover it. But if you're at risk, I would definitely encourage you to get the HPV vaccine.
And you know, in recent years, doctor, we've been hearing that some older men have actually contracted this. Is this happening more these days, or is
yes,
it just
definitely.
Being reported more, and why?
I think it's just being reported more, and then, you know, we have the men who were not exposed to the HPV vaccine, and so now we're starting to see more of those cases, oral, anal.
And maybe to make
cancer.
Parents more comfortable, just take the sex factor out of it. Just say this is to protect you against a future cancers.
And
period,
usually the like teenagers don't even know what vaccines they're getting anyways.
True.
So 11 to 12 years old is just one of the routine vaccines you get. Is less than 1% that'll get an adverse outcome from the vaccine.
Okay.
All right.